Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. This is episode 650, which means it's our 550th episode. If you weren't around in podcast 600, I'm giving away this book, Learn Excel from Mr. Excel. It's the new version, has 100 new tips, and applies to both Excel 2003 and to Excel 2007. About 50 new tips in there for Excel 2007 and 50 new tips that apply to everything. To get the book, the ebook, go to MrExcel.com/pod650.html. You can download an ebook that'll look fine on your screen. It probably isn't great for printing, but it's the whole book. Just feel free to get it and share that with your coworkers too. I'm trying to give away 5 million copies of the book. So this week we're going to take a look at some of the new things in Excel 2007. I just got back from months on the road, and I'm starting to see more and more people switching over to Excel 2007, and a lot of big companies are talking about switching over at the first of the year or the first of February. So I wanted to kind of take a look again at Excel 2007 and some of the amazing things that are in there. The first thing I want to take a look at today is what we used to have in Excel was called the auto filter, and now they've just simply called it the filter. At first glance, it does exactly what it did before. We get little drop downs at the top of every column, and we can go through and select a specific customer. So if we want to just see Bank of America records, that's easy enough to do, or we could select all to see all the records. But one of the real cool things that they added here is when you have a date. If you have a date column, it used to be that you would open this drop down and would just have a list of all the dates, which really wasn't that useful at all. Well, now they automatically group things up to year, and even within year, we can now see it by month. So, like, really, what do you want to do? We want to see everything that happened maybe last month. So, what we could do is uncheck select all, and then go through and say, I want to see just the November records. Click OK, and now we have all the records from one specific month. This is a great improvement over what we had before with the auto filter. It's very easy to go through now and find things in a certain range. They've also added some additional text filters. So, for example, it's a little bit easier now. We don't have to go into custom to create filters that say everything that contains bank or does not contain Walmart or, you know, whatever we might need to do there. And then also, finally, with the numbers, they created some number filters. We can say that we want to see everything above average or everything in the top 10. Now, we had top 10 before, but above average and below average are new. Or we can say that we want to see only the sales above $10,000 or something like that. So, fantastic new improvements to what used to be called the auto filter, but is now just simply the filter in Excel 2007. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.